on YouTube. Moose78 back at you with some more American Truck Simulator. This is my ATS Let's Play series, Stories on the Road. I upload this every Tuesday and Thursday. Hope you guys are doing well. Hope you had a great weekend. But we are back in American Truck Simulator, and we are continuing our trip over to Flagstaff. We're just east of Bakersfield here. Of course, still in the Western Star 4900 FA. Loving this truck. Looks great. Sounds great. All around great mod. But we're gonna hop out here and get back after it. So what are we doing on fuel? Half a tank. Place right across the street. Probably a good call to go over and get a little go-go juice before we get going. Has a feel, AI. So I probably should have waited for that pickup, but oh well. See, I think I finally got the track IR all sorted out. I was messing around a little bit before I started recording today. And I think I got it all sorted out and set back up the way I want it, so pretty pleased about that. There we go. Seems like the SKRS is shifting a lot better between high and low now too. Hopefully that keeps up. So far that's really been the only issue I've had with the SKRS shifter. Not sure if it's just a loose cable or what it is, but seems like it's working okay now, so we'll keep an eye on that. Getting pretty excited though. The Battlefield 1 beta is pretty much here. So this video is going to go up on a Tuesday, but I'm recording on a Monday. So by the time this goes live, the beta, BF1 beta, could be live itself. So I'm pretty excited for that. I'll have all sorts of content up on the channel for Battlefield 1. I do some pub rounds, things like that. I'll do some initial impressions and all that good stuff as well. If you guys are interested in that, be sure to check that out. Keep an eye out for that. Oh. Yeah, I turned the precision feature on in track IR, and I think I like that a lot better. I don't feel like my head's whipping around at 1,000 miles an hour. Just a little service station with some scales, so we don't have to stop there, of course. Speed here just a little bit and get the cruise control set, and here we go. Say, when I'm in California, I always try to run the cruise right at 58. Seems like they give you a 3 mile an hour leeway. Seems like anything over 58, they always ticket you. Of stuff to work on this week, a lot of stuff that I want to get out, that hopefully I can get out. Of course, the two stories from the road on Tuesdays and Thursdays, want to get those done and uploaded and out to you guys this week without any kind of delays. Still need to do the graphic settings video. Hopefully I can get that done today as well. So kind of my goal today is to get a whole bunch of stuff recorded, get this particular video edited, and then you know, kind of throughout the week get the other stuff edited up in a timely manner. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do for Wednesday's video yet. You know, maybe between now and then, SES will drop some more news on us about the map rescale, but there's not been a whole lot of news about that, so kind of thought about taking this week's video and just kind of doing like a general discussion about the game. I guess that's kind of what all the map rescale videos have kind of been, but just this one, you know, won't really pertain at all to the map rescale. It'll just be kind of a general discussion on a couple topics. See, now we're back to it not wanting to go into the high range. I don't know, might have to reach out to those guys and see if that's kind of a known issue, or if there's something that can, you know, be done to fix that. That's kind of annoying though. Scale must be closed. I don't think I got flagged for it. I really wasn't paying a whole lot of attention there because I'm trying to get this. I guess we're just running low. back out and resume the cruise. Don't half expect them. Okay. I was expecting that car to completely pull out in front of us there. I guess we'll just camp out here in the left-hand lane for a little bit and get around all these trucks. I have no idea what that was. Looked like a floating parking meter. Yeah, several videos I want to get out this week. Still want to get, hopefully, maybe I can get that W900 out to you guys this week as well. Probably if I do get it, be towards the end of the week. Still want to check on getting the utility reefer out to you guys as well. I know several people have asked about that. I just think that'd be a good thing to get out to the community. Because if that's one thing you always need, some good trailer mods. But I'll talk a little bit about that more in Wednesday's video. It's the topic of trailer mods and stuff like that. Now, this is one of my favorite spots in the game here. Nice scenic view. Logistics area ahead. There it goes, finally. Dadgum. Yeah, the first few times I used the SKRS did not have any issues, but so far that's been the only issue I have, is getting it to go from low to high. I don't know if it's just a loose cable in there or what, but yeah, I think I'm going to reach out to those guys and see if I can't get some feedback on that. See if that's a known issue or kind of what's going on with that. So the crew's right there at 65. That seems to keep me out of trouble. I guess I got it set at 68, but that should keep me out of trouble as well. Speed limit 65, so we got that 3 mile an hour leeway, so we should be good. I am going to go ahead, since traffic's going right at 65. Okay, now it's up to 75, so we'll set the cruise right there about 69, 70. Been messing around with the two Western Stars just a little bit. I want to add some modifications to those, kind of get those into the rotation for the content. That way, you know, I'm not using the exact same truck over and over. And what in God's name is traffic doing up here? You know, I want to use both Western Stars, and I also want to jump into the 377. Because the one episode that I did with that, I really did enjoy it. Love the interior on that truck. And it just looks amazing in this game. And I just like the clean, neat appearance of the 377 as well. It does need a little bit of work, not a great deal. But hopefully in the next couple weeks, get to all that stuff done and just kind of get kind of a general rotation of trucks going. Maybe throw the W900 in there as well. Just kind of have like a four truck rotation that way. Keeps a little bit fresh for you guys. You know, I know some of you guys really like the W900 and like seeing that. I know a couple of you guys like seeing the 377 and enjoy that. And I've also had some comments already on the Western Stars, so just keep it fresh and get you guys the trucks you like to see. And of course the trucks I enjoy driving and stuff like that. But the Peterbilts, you know, the W900s, the 379s. Of course, you know, I do know the Kenworth is or the W900 is a Kenworth, so. But yeah, those style of trucks, these Western Stars, those are really the style of trucks that I kind of like. Trailer brakes for the win. Ooh. I don't know why, but the exit ramps in Arizona just kind of throw me off a little bit. Well, let's see how far off route we're going to be. We're going to be that far off at all. Oh, shoot. We were pretty much right there at Flagstaff. Dadgummit. So we just got to get turned around. Man, son of a gun. I don't want to go all the way back down here just to get. It looks like that's what we're going to have to do. Shenanigans. Really don't want to have to go all the way back down to Camp Ver just to get turned around to get back up here to Flagstaff. What do you do, though? What do you do? Headed back the right way. There we go. Easy does it, big fella. Easy does it. See this? I This just drives me nuts. So I turn my turn signal off, all the traffic just goes freely. Not a problem. But when I turn signal on... Okay. Let's see how it is. I guess it must be hit or miss then. Still the worst part of this game are the ramps. Just specifically the on-ramps. That's just ridiculous. At least we're going back in the right direction now. Let's make sure I don't miss my exit this time. Gotta love that 75 to 25 right now speed limit. But hey, we can see the destination there on the mini map, so that's good. To get over here. Yeah, well, I'm trying to get over, so... I think... Instead of trying to make that turn there, all the traffic... Looks like we can just go up here and catch our turn. Yeah. Looks like that might be just a more direct route to where we're delivering to, so. That way we're not zigzagging through town all the way. That light was going to change it all. Walbert. See what kind of fun and excitement we can get into here. This. Right about there. So I don't know if this is one of the ones I can go all the way around or not. Let's say that it is. Try to do. Alright, cool. Yeah, we can drive all the way around this, so that's good. I'm gonna get a quick screenshot here before I forget. There we go. I wish there were a lot more places to deliver to like this. Could still be a little bit bigger, but it's better than a lot of the places we have to deliver to in game. At least I can circle around the building and get a, you know, hopefully a little bit better approach. No, I'm not ready to skip the parking yet. Give me a couple minutes though. Ooh. Yeah, that's close. You know, this way at least I can kind of pull up a little bit. Try to go at it like this. Four ways on. probably have to pull it up at least once. So far, so good. It's kind of working out as planned. It's kind of crazy. That never happens. What? No freaking way. No way. First time. Shut the front door. Not too shabby. I will take it. Rock on, Whitesnake. And I have video proof that I was able to back a trailer up pretty okay on the first try. Well, guys, on that note, that is going to wrap it up for today's episode of Stories on the Road. If you like today's video, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch, helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please consider doing so now. Love to have you around. A lot of good stuff coming up on the channel that I don't think you want to miss. But guys, I'm going to cut on out of here. Until the next video, stay safe out there. Take care, and we'll be seeing ya. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing. Also, if you want to follow me over on the Twitters, follow the link down in the video description. And if you're looking for great gaming gear at an affordable price, then be sure to check out my NoScope Gaming Glasses affiliate link, also down in the video description. And lastly, I upload 3 days a week, so be sure to check down below for my various content playlists for any videos you may have missed. Until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you.